Hey guys, Paul from Ultimate Fat Burner here, and today I'm going to talk about a fairly new type of creatine you're seeing more and more often in your supplements. It's called creatine hydrochloride or creatine HCL. In this review, I'm going to compare it to creatine monohydrate and see how it stacks up. In just a couple of minutes, you'll know everything you need to know about creatine HCL and whether or not you should take it. I'll be back in just a couple of seconds. Stick around. Don't go anywhere. All right, welcome back. So let's get into our discussion. On one hand, we have the gold standard of creatine, creatine monohydrate. It's been proven effective in increasing anaerobic performance time after time after time in study after study. It's been studied extensively for its therapeutic uses as well in people with heart disease, fibromyalgia, muscular dystrophy, and more. On the other hand, we have this fairly new type of creatine called creatine hydrochloride or creatine HCL. Creatine HCL is creatine bonded to a hydrochloride group to make it more stable. We're being told it's a much more effective creatine. It's extremely soluble, which means it's easily absorbed and utilized by the body. We're being told it's also less likely to cause bloating and nausea. But what do we really know about creatine HCL? Let's dig down deep and discuss the clinical studies that have been performed on creatine HCL. Oh, right, my mistake. There have been no clinical studies performed on creatine hydrochloride. That's right, there's no evidence to either prove or disprove the claims that are currently being made for it. And what about the claims that it reduces bloating? Well, creatine bloat, believe it or not, isn't actually even a thing. Studies have found that there's no correlation between creatine use and bloating. All that really exists now to justify the use of creatine HCL over creatine monohydrate is anecdotal evidence. What do I mean by anecdotal evidence? Well, what I mean essentially is word of mouth comments and testimonials. And unfortunately, anecdotal evidence doesn't mean much because we human beings are horrible witnesses and subject to all sorts of biases, whether we know it or not. That's why the double-blind, placebo-controlled, peer-reviewed clinical study is the current gold standard for proof. To make matters worse, anecdotal reports of success on the internet are even harder to assign value to because you can't determine whether they are genuine and originate from a real user or whether they're testimonials that a retailer has purchased to make the product appear as if it has fantastic fan support. Now you might say, hey Paul, listen, there's a lot of really smart people right now who argue that creatine HCL is a superior form of creatine and that's what I should be taking. What do you say to that? Well, I'd say actually three things. Number one, it really doesn't matter how smart you are. If you can't support your arguments with published clinical studies, you're just presenting anecdotal evidence as fact. That's the bottom line. The second thing I say is that the people recommending creatine HCL usually have a financial conflict of interest. In other words, they're trying to sell their own creatine HCL-based products, or they're earning commissions on the referred sales of such products. So their recommendations really need to be viewed with a hearty degree of skepticism. And the last thing I'd say is, this isn't the first time the supplement industry has tried to sell us other types of creatine, claiming they were much better than creatine monohydrate. Remember liquid creatine? Not better. Remember creatine ethyl ester? Not more effective. Remember buffered creatine? Not more effective. See, the problem with creatine monohydrate, as far as the supplement industry is concerned, is that it's dirt frickin' cheap. You can buy a 400 gram jug of Allmax CreaPure creatine for $11 at bodybuilding.com. At a 5 gram per day maintenance dose, that's gonna last you 80 days, almost 3 months. The supplement industry does not make money selling you creatine monohydrate. That's the bottom line. Think about it. If they were able to convince you to buy a creatine product that costs $30 a month, over 3 months, that's close to an 800% increase in revenue, $90 compared to $11. At any rate, let's get back to the bottom line. At this time, the bottom line on creatine HCL is pretty straightforward. It may work as well as creatine monohydrate. It may not work as well. It may even be better, but we really don't know. Now, if you want to experiment with it, be my guest. Go right ahead, just as long as you recognize that the claims being made for creatine HCL are more about marketing spin than actual fact. If you have your own comments or experiences on creatine hydrochloride or creatine monohydrate for that matter that you'd like to share, please do leave those comments below. Love to hear from you. And if you haven't done so already, please do subscribe to our channel so you can be updated whenever we post new videos. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you soon.